Hello, my name is Stefan Gisler from the Barrick support team, and in this video I will show you how to use the Bell Commander software together with Barrick's audio devices. Audio scheduling software from the company AcroVista. From this homepage here you can even download the trial version, or you can even purchase this software. The software was made, as the name says already, to schedule bell sounds. So to start or stop the lesson, but it can be used for many other applications. So we have even a live audio, live paging function, and we can even send network commands. We can schedule network commands and send this to devices. So this application can be used even for campus application in factories, or even for transport applications. Let's have a look how that works. Here on this screen, I have three windows. We have here the Bell Commander software. We have here the Barrick's Xtremer M400 device. And here on the bottom, we have the Xtremer 100 device. So let me show you how to integrate the devices into the Bell Commander. We go here on devices, and there I have already integrated the Xtremer M400 and the Xtremer 100. Let's check the settings here. We're going to advanced settings. There you see I use the RTP protocol with port number 4444, and the audio files are sent with MP3. Then we have here the live audio. This is sent with Mühler and even sent with RTP to port number 4x4. And in the general tab, we have market send UDP RTP audio if ping fails. That's necessary because the Xtremer M400 does not support the device detection. For that reason, you see even faults here, but no problem. The streaming works nevertheless. Let's have a look on the audio devices, on the settings of the audio devices. So we go first to the Xtremer M400. Here on sources, you see we have RTP configured, and we have here the RTP listen port configured and the playback mode low latency. That's all you have to do. Let's have a look on the Xtremer streaming client. We go to configuration, advanced settings, and here under streaming, you see even the RTP port 4x4 is configured. That's already default settings. The default background music channel, the Barrick's radio, I have deleted for this example. And I have changed the fade in period. Default is long, and I changed this to none, because for live paging, this is very important. Otherwise you will lose the beginning of the audio, because with the fade in function, when you have long, then the volume is ramping up slowly and you will miss part of the paging. Instead of this URL1, you could even use the priority port, which you have here on this tab. But in this case, make sure you use a different port number, or you delete here the URL1. You should not use 2x the same port number on the device. Okay, let's go back to the streaming page. On this page here, and even on the M400, you see the state of the streaming. So if you receive a state here, the status and the bitrate and buffer will change. And here on the M400, this RTP will change, and here this will getting red. Okay, let's test this even. We have here even a test function. So the Xtremer M400 is selected. We select here and file. Okay, let's use this one here. Open, and then we play the audio. You see this is changing. It has received the audio. Let's do the same even with the Xtremer 100. Even that is changing the status, and you see buffer and bitrate. So the configuration is working at all. Then let's check what other functions we have here. We have here a zone manager. In the zone manager, you can assign devices to zones. I have created a zone all, where both devices are assigned. And then I have a zone A and zone B, and here one zone for one device only. Okay, now we have the day scheduler. On the day schedule, I have here created a day schedule, and two times I have already configured two actions. So here you configure the actions, you define the time and the zone and the file name or the action, what should be done. So let's have a look here in this one. You can see we can play an audio file, or we can even send a command, a network command. So, and let's now define a time. So we have 7:02. So, okay. And the same we do here. Okay, that's done. Oh, we have the same time. Let's check. Then let's, oh, sorry, that's wrong here. This one, we increase one. Okay, now we have different times that we can check this separately. We still have a lot of time. Okay. Then we have here the calendar. In the calendar, you can here set the default schedule. I have here configured my schedule test. Then you can set even exceptions. So there you can say no bells and no actions at a defined time. For example, for holidays or for public holidays or weekends or whatever. And here you have even an overview about the actions which will be executed. So let's check. Okay, soon will be played the action for zone B. So a few seconds, then we should see that zone B is the Xtremer 100. Here you see it. Okay. The Bell Commander software allows also the integration of the Barracks Baronet. I have not integrated this here, but on the Barracks Baronet is our network IO module. You could trigger the input and then it sends a notification and Bell Commander will receive, and then you can assign any action to this notification. For example, so you can trigger a fire alarm and the software will play the fire alarm. The same you can even do reverse. You can send network commands from Bell Commander, for example, to trigger the Barracks Baronet relay, even scheduled. Okay, now soon the action for the Xtremer M400. You will see that here. There you hear and see it is playing the audio. Next, what we can do is the intercom function. With the intercom function, we can stream live audio from the microphone directly from the PC to the Barracks device or to a configured zone. You can record and play a message, or you can even play a pre-recorded message from here. So let's use this stream live audio. Next, we select the zone. I will talk to both zones at the same time and start that broadcast audio. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. You see the devices receiving the audio stream and play it. So we have some echo, for that reason I stopped that. That is a short overview what you can do with the Bell Commander software. It's a very helpful tool. It's very reliable. It's available for different operating systems. More information you can find on the Acrovista homepage. Barracks has even some help for that. There you can find that on the help.barracks.com page. When you go there to Xstreamer and then to add-ons and how-tos. Here you will find the Barracks Bell Commander guide. There you will see how to integrate the Barracks devices for the Xstreamer M400. There is still nothing added, but that will come soon. If you have any further questions to this video or to this topic here, then please send an email to support@barracks.com. I hope you liked the video. Thanks for watching.